Welcome to my first self-made video for Math 1175. This will be an introduction to the first topic of Unit 3, which is deferred annuities. This is coming from section 11.1 of the textbook. This is where Unit 3 begins, with deferred annuities. So you probably have already looked at what a deferred annuity is. Of course, we are talking about periodic payments that are going to begin only after a certain waiting period or interval of time, which is called the deferral period. And this process is always going to consist of two calculations. One is going to be the compound interest calculation, which is where we need to carefully decide on our deferral period. And we will also, of course, have the annuity calculation, which has to do with the periodic payment part. We have to be careful about how we are choosing this deferral period based on how we set up the annuity. So we want to make sure that there is no overlap of interest calculations. We don't want it to be calculating twice for the same period of time. So I think the best way to go through this is just to do an example. So let's look at this one. What amount should you invest now if you want to receive payments of $3,000 at the end of each year for 10 years with the receipt of the first payment 3 years from now? We will assume that money earns 5% compounded annually. So there is actually more than one way to get to this answer. I will go through two methods for finding the solution. The first one I'm going to go into more detail with. So this will be, of course, a compound interest calculation. And we'll also have an annuity calculation specifically where the calculator is set in end mode. However, it is actually also possible to do the same type of question with the other method, which is where the calculator is actually set in begin mode for the annuity. However, the deferral period will be a little bit longer than method number one. So I'm going to spend more time on method number one. However, you can choose whatever you prefer. We'll just look for the differences here so you can choose correctly. And I will be using, of course, the financial calculator to do these calculations. So I need to set up the tables just like you're given on your tests so you can see how that will look. So let's begin with method one. I'm going to start by setting up my timeline so that I can organize my thinking and be sure that I set up my tables correctly as well. So, first, reading through the question, of course, we're trying to find what we should invest now. So I'm going to start my timeline with now being time zero. I also look next to the fact that we're having payments of $3,000 that are starting 3 years from now. So onto my timeline, around year three, I can put payment number one of $3,000. And of course, this implies an annuity. So my first table here is going to be an annuity calculation. And obviously I have put $3,000 in for the payment. So the next thing I want to do is take a look at whether I'm going to set my calculator to end or begin mode. It's given in the question, of course, that we're talking about end of each year for 10 years, so I can make a choice to set this up in end mode. And that makes it pretty easy to look at the next step, which is finding the value of n. The payments are occurring, of course, for 10 years at the end of each year. So PY is 1 and n is obviously 10 here. That means, of course, there's 10 payments in total. So year 3 is actually the first payment. Then we're going to have the 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, and 10th payment actually occurring in year 12. Of course, at this time, there is going to be no future value. We have $0 left at this point. Future value is 0, so I can put that into my table as well. Lastly, fill in the rest of the spots. I know that the interest rate is 5%, so I'm going to put 5 for IY, and the compounding period is 1 because it is annually compounded. So that fills in everything I know in the table. As I mentioned, we are setting our calculator to end mode. So the present value that I'm looking for here is actually going to be sitting and collecting interest for 1 year before that first payment comes out. So I'm looking for the present value at year two, essentially. So from this point, you could take a moment to start to put these numbers into your calculator, being careful, of course, that it's set in end mode. So I need to choose N of 10, 5 for IY, 1 for PY and CY, payment is $3,000, future value 0. Then, of course, I just need to compute. So I'm going to press compute and then present value. And hopefully you're following along with me and you also get the same number as I get here. Obviously, it's going to be negative. So we have negative $23,165. And then keep all the decimals there. So keep that 0.20479, whatever shows on your calculator screen, because we want to take that exact value when we put it into the next set of calculations that we need to do. So this is what I need to have at year two. But of course, we're trying to figure out what I need to have now. So I need to kind of work backwards from here. That is going to be a compound interest calculation. I'm not going to put in any more money after time zero. So it's just going to sit and collect interest, compound interest, for those first 2 years there. So that will be the future value for my compound interest calculation. And I want to make sure to use that exact value in my calculator. So the way that I change that number, since I actually want that to be positive and I want it to be the future value, is I'm going to type or use the plus minus button, then hit recall present value. So that'll give me the positive of the present value that you see there. And I want to put that in future value. So I'm going to hit future value after that, and it's going to give me that number in my calculator under future value. Now, of course, we need the rest of the values for the compound interest calculation. As I mentioned, we're working backwards for 2 years, so I need N to be 2. So even though the first payment is not happening until 3 years from now, I'm already collecting interest for a year at year 2. So I'm working backwards and using 2 for N in the compound interest calculation instead. And from there, it's not so hard to realize, of course, that I need to find the present value. I'm working backwards. And I can fill in the rest. This is a compound interest calculation, so there's never a payment for that. Payment is zero. The interest rate and the compounding periods have not changed. So IY is 5, PY and CY are both 1. So I'm ready now to think about what my present value would be. I just need to go ahead and compute that value. And I should have less at time zero or now than I did at year two, because it's sitting there and collecting interest for 2 years. So last but not least, now you can see how much I needed to deposit into my bank account at time zero, so that I would end up with being able to make 10 payments of $3,000 starting in year three. So last but not least, I can say that we should invest $21,011.52 now. So that's method one. Make note of that number. Hopefully you were following along. I should get that number, same number, even if I use a slightly different method, if I've done it correctly. So let's take a look a little more quickly at how I can do this if I set my calculator a little differently and set my timeline up a little differently as well. So going on to method two, I'm going to set up my annuity calculation exactly the same as I set it up for method one, except for whether it's going to be in end mode. This time, of course, I would like to choose begin mode instead, just to demonstrate the difference in how the interest is calculated and to show you how to choose your deferral period if you want to do it this way. So that being said, if it's in begin mode, my payment of $3,000 is being made before any interest has been accumulated in that annuity. So that is going to happen at year three, immediately at year three, and then interest after that. So what that means to me is now I have those 3 years where no interest has been accumulated yet. So that present value at year three, same idea as before. I just need to set my calculator to begin mode before I choose my or compute my present value. I still want to use that as my future value in my compound interest calculation. Of course, we need to do the same thing with that storing and recalling. The rest of the compound interest table looks exactly the same as before, except, as you can see now, we're going back 3 years. It needs to collect interest for 3 years to accumulate enough to have $3,000 for 10 years. So I will choose N to be 3. That is literally the only difference in the compound interest calculation. So I set my calculator to begin mode, and it turns out that I can use the exact value given in the question for the deferral period, the 3 years there. So anytime I'm in begin mode, it can work just like this. So from there, same idea, I just need to compute the present value prior to those 3 years of interest accumulation. And of course, I should recognize this number. This should be exactly the same as what we got with method one. And of course it is. So again, I'm still needing to invest $21,011.52. Just a matter of how I set it up. So the great thing is that you can choose. You just have to make a careful decision on that. So that is only one example. Hopefully it adds something to what you're already doing with your studying. If you would like to practice some more, I have created a little mini online quiz, just a multiple choice quiz. You can go to this link and type in any name, actually, when it asks for a name. Click continue and choose the multiple choice answers that you think are best. Just hit submit and it will tell you immediately if those answers were correct or incorrect. If they were incorrect, feel free to go and try them all again. It's not for marks. It's just for a way for you to self-check, make sure that you know that you've understood what you need to understand for this lesson. So hopefully that gives a little insight into deferred annuities. Thank you for your time and happy studying.